In this session, we will discuss the limitation of finite automata and discuss the design of Millet machine. Let's start the session. In case of DFA, we will say either the string is rejected or accepted. DFA cannot able to remember what has been read in the past. It can only able to remember that any instant of time, we are in a particular state KY. And our read-write head is pointing to a particular symbol, let's call it as A. It will not able to remember the symbol that we had processed in the past. So another alternate of the finite automata is design of Millet and Moore machine. In case of Millet and Moore machine, we will give some input string, let's call it as W, and we will get output string as the output from the output alphabets. Instant of acceptance and rejection, we will get output string. Millet and Moore machines are useful for designing the digital circuit. A Millet machine can be defined by 6 tuple: Q, sigma, Q0, delta, that is transition function, output function, and output alphabets. Where Q is a finite non-empty set of state, sigma is an alphabet, Q0 is an initial state, tau is an output alphabets, delta is a transition function, that is on reading a particular symbol on a particular state, we will move to a particular state. Omega is the output function specified by Q, sigma will move to output alphabets. In case of Millet and Moore machine, there is no concept of final state. Output in case of Millet machine will depend upon state as well as on input symbols. Suppose we want to design a Millet machine that perform one complement over 0 and 1. Suppose given sigma is 0 and 1 and if input string is W, that is 0, 1, 1. So output is one complement, that is if you will read 0, it will be changed into 1. If you will read 1, that is changed into 0. 1, that is changed into 0. So let's suppose Q0 is our initial state. If we will read 0, we will change it into 1. If we will read 1, output symbol is 0. So we will specify input symbol and on the other side we will specify the output symbol. So on reading of 0, we are generating 1 as output. On reading of 1, we are generating 0 as the output. Now consider input string is 011. So in Q0, we will read 0 and we will move to Q0 state and we will generate output as 1. On reading of 1 on Q0, we will move to Q0 and we will generate 0 as output. On reading of 1 again, we will move to Q0 and we will generate 0 as output. So output is 100. Input string length is 3. Length of input string is 3 as well as length of output is also 3. So if input string is of length n in case of Millet machine, output string length is also n. Now suppose we want to design a Millet machine over 0 and 1 and it will output even and odd according to the number of 0 is even or odd. So this is suppose our initial state. We need to keep track of number of 0. So if we will read 0, number of 0 will become odd and we will print output as odd and we will move to Q1 state. And if we will read 0 again on Q1, number of 0 will become even and we will move to Q0 state. So Q0 state is representing even number of 0 and Q1 state is representing odd number of 0. If we will read 1, we will output as even. If we will read 1 on Q1, we will output as odd. For example, given the input string as 0, 0, 1. So on reading of 0, we will move to Q1 and we will put output as odd. On reading of 0 again, we will move to Q0, we will put output as even. And then on reading of 1, we will remain in Q0 and output as even. The last put symbol will indicate the number of 0 is even or odd. In this particular case, number of 0 is even, so the last output is even. Now we want to design a MILLE machine that perform increment operation over 0 and 1. If input is 0, 1, 1, the output will be addition of 1 to that 1. So we will get 1, 0, 0. We will assume our read-write head will point to the rightmost symbol. That is, in this particular case, it is pointing to this symbol. And on reading a particular symbol, we will move from right to left. So for designing this MILLE machine, we will consider two cases. One is no carry state and another is carry state. So from the initial state, if we will read 0, if the last symbol is 0, we will change that into 1 and we will move into the no carry state. If the last symbol is 1 and we will perform increment on this one, the last output will be 0, like the last symbol in this case is 0, 1, 1. So if we will add 1 to it, output is 0. So this will be the output, that is 0, and we will move into the carry state. On the carry state, if we will read 1, like in this particular case, if we will add 1 to 1, we will get 0 as the output and we will remain in carry state. But if suppose in this case it will be 0 over here, so on reading of 0, we will generate output as 1 and we will move to no carry state. In no carry state, if we will read 0, we will generate output as 0. If we will read 1, we will generate 1 as the output. Suppose the given input is 100 and we are in Q0 state. The last symbol is 0, we will read 0. And on incrementing, we will get 1 as the output. So this is the symbol that we are reading and this is the output that we are generating. We will move to no carry state. In no carry state, if we will read 0, we will print 0. If we will read 1, we will print as 1 as the output. Thanks for watching this session.